Hi everyone, this is Begüm Baloğlu. Today we will talk about paradoxes. Paradox is a situation in which cause and effect are intersected, so contradicting with one another. Oxford Dictionary says, a seemingly absurd or contradictory statement or proposition which when investigated may prove to be well-founded or true. A person or thing that combines some contradictory features or qualities. Contradiction is a statement that is false according to formal logic. However, paradoxes can be proven both true and false. We can see that in ancient times, philosophers who studied mathematics, logic, physics, and theology thought about paradoxes. Some paradoxes happened by themselves, but some others are created by those people. The latter paradoxes caused new discoveries in mathematics, and they also fed the abstract thinking. As mathematics improved, new paradoxes emerged. Let's put those mathematical paradoxes aside, as they take time to explain and give shorter examples. Someone writes a sentence and it says, "Don't read this sentence." You read it, but it says the opposite. Well, what about this? This sentence is wrong. If the information in the sentence is wrong, the sentence is true. If the information is true, then the sentence is false. Socrates, true knowledge exists in knowing that you know nothing. Well, if you know nothing, then there will be no knowledge. If there is knowledge, that means we know something. So, this is a good dilemma. One of the greatest rulers of the Ottoman Empire was Fatih the Conqueror. He earned this title after he conquered the Constantinople and renamed it as Istanbul. Before the conquest, when he was 12 years old, he became the ruler of the empire. As he was very young, crusaders started a war on Ottoman Empire. Young Mehmet wanted her father lead the Ottoman army. So he wrote a letter and there was a paradox in it. If you are the Sultan, come and lead your armies. If I am the Sultan, I hereby order you to come and lead my armies. What about this dress? Is it blue and black or yellow and white? This is a visual paradox. If a person says, "I always tell lies," then is this a true or false sentence? If what he says true, then the sentence is false. If what he says is false, then the sentence is true. Now, I am asking, is the sentence true? A paradox is also a good way for training our brains. Our brain has to think one or more steps beforehand. We can say that they are mind training games like Sudoku or Go. Okay, that is all for now. See you in the next videos. Let your brains handle some paradoxes. If you search for it, you can find many paradoxes by your own. Because life is strange, and as the curly MC says, there are.